Good day students, today we will learn computer subject for standard 4. Children, today we will learn lesson number 9, that is memory of computer. So, do you know human memory? Children, we are having a memory, and because of our memory, we can remember lots of things. And you know, we can store lots of work on computer also. I think you have heard that we can store lots of work on a computer. Like our memory, computer is also having a memory. Okay? So next, we will see computer's memory. So every computer has a certain amount of memory that is depend on that computer or on us, that how we are store a memory. So it may be either internal or external. Internal or external means what? Computer is having some internal memory inside the computer, that is a internal memory. And external means what? Whichever memory we can store externally. I thought you know about a pen drive. So on a pen drive you can store a memory. Yes or no? Yes. So that is an external memory, because that pen drive is not a computer part. That is a part which you can store for your memory. Okay. So that is an external memory. So, children, now we will see the chart of that computer memory. So, memory is having two types. We can divide the memory into two parts. First is primary memory and second is secondary memory. So, children, always keep in mind that there are two types of memory. Primary memory and secondary memory. So see this primary memory option. So primary memory is having RAM and ROM. This is a internal memory. Primary memory means what? Internal memory of a computer. And secondary memory means what? External memory. So primary memory is having RAM and ROM, and secondary memory is having hard disk, floppy disk, CD-ROM, DVD, etc. Understood everyone? Okay. Now, let's see primary memory. So, primary memory is a main memory of a computer. It stores the chips located on the motherboard. Inside the computer CPU, you can see a chip located on the motherboard. Understood? I will show you the picture of that chip so you will understand. And this primary memory holds all information that tells the computer how to work. This primary memory is important because it holds all the information that tells the computer how to work. So, children, this primary memory is having RAM and ROM. That as I know, I said. So, in a RAM, RAM means what? First of all, the full form of RAM is random access memory. What? Random access memory. So, children, you can see this chip that I was talking about. This chip is called RAM. Okay. So, this RAM is a temporary memory of the computer. The information on RAM can be lost when you switch off the computer. It is a temporary memory. When you are typing something, you can see that. But if you didn't save that file, then your information will lost when you switch off the computer. Okay. Now, next is ROM. So, what is the full form of ROM? Read only memory. Read only memory. So children, see this picture carefully. This read-only memory is a permanent memory of the computer. Understood? Whatever you save the file and folder, that will be in the computer only. So that is a ROM. Understood? It doesn't lose the information when you switch off the computer, like the RAM. In RAM, if we didn't save any file, that information will lost after switch off the computer. But in a ROM, you are save the information, so that information is saved in a ROM. So that information will not lost. Understood? So next is secondary memory. So secondary memory is a external memory. Okay, secondary memory is also called auxiliary memory. Okay, students. So we can store large amount of data and information for a long time by using the secondary memory, because that primary memory is internal memory in a computer only. If your computer will not work, that memory will lose. But that is not in the case of secondary memory. Secondary memory you can use for storing large amount of information, like what? Like pen drive. Okay, so secondary memory is a hard disk, floppy disk, CD, ROM, DVD ROM, etc., and pen drive also. Okay, so let's see. So first is hard disk. Hard disk is a basic storage device of a computer. It is fixed on the motherboard inside the computer. Actually, this is an external memory, but we can add that hard disk inside the CPU cabinet. Okay, all the programs and data of the computer are stored in it, in this hard disk. Okay, so when you start the computer, hard disk begin loading the operating system of that computer, and you can store large amount of data on this hard disk. Which of the type you have taken that hard disk means for 20 GB to 1000 GB are available nowadays for the hard disk. So you can store large amount of data by using this hard disk. See this picture carefully. This is a hard disk. You can keep this hard disk in a cabinet of that CPU. Okay, so next is floppy disk. Floppy disk is a thin and flexible magnetic storage device. Understood? So it is a removable disk. This is just a 3.5 inch size with a 1.44 MB storage capacity. The storage capacity of floppy disk is 1.44 MB. Okay, so see this floppy disk and how you will insert that floppy disk where the floppy disk drive. So see this picture. This is a floppy disk drive. In this floppy disk drive, you can insert that floppy disk. Okay. Next is CD or DVD. I think you have seen this CD or DVD. So these are the CD or DVD. You know that this is the shape of this CD is circle. So you can store 4.1 GB to 20 GB storage or information in this CD or DVD. Understood you all? Now see this CD or DVD drive. So where you will insert the CD or DVD? Like this, on a CPU. Okay, there is a small button and you can insert the CD or DVD into that computer, and you can load your information, you can copy paste information in this CD and DVD. Okay, so next is flash drive. So flash drive means what? That is also known as pen drive. Okay, so this is a pen drive. This is a removable drive. Okay, so and rewritable also. Means what? You can copy paste your file on the pen drive, and if you want to edit any file, you can do it. This is a rewritable drive. So the storage capacity range from 64 MB to 256 GB. Okay, we will see the this units of memory in the next video. What do you mean by GB and MB and how many are etc. Okay, so this pen drive contain so many information. You can store so many information on this pen drive. They contain a more compact shape. This operate fast and a small in a size. Okay, so next is memory card. Children, see this. This is a memory card. I think you have seen this memory card. We can use this memory card for our phone also, mobile phone. So they are also known as multimedia card also. So the storage capacity of the memory card is 256 MB to 64 GB. This many information you can store on this memory card. This memory card can be accessed by using a computer and using a multimedia card also. There are a memory card reader also. So by using that memory card reader, you can shift your information from mobile to computer also by using that memory card. See this memory card. So you can just insert your memory card into this memory card reader, and you can shift your information, you can move your information from computer to mobile or mobile to computer also. Okay, so next lesson we will learn in the next video. Okay, so thank you students for learning this information, and please read this lesson and see this video 2 times. Okay, thank you students.